What up guys, the name is Izzy and welcome to the channel. Yeah, it's the just released Technocamera 17 Pro and you just saw it unboxed at the intro of this video. Not to worry, we are going to see the rest of the items bundled in the box shortly. The Technocamera 17 Pro is more of a successor to the Camera 16 Premiere and this goes for 125,000 Naira. That is about $300. Currently, when you purchase the Technocamera 17 Pro, you'll be gifted with a pair of Techno True Wireless Earbuds. First off, I have to say this is the fastest Techno phone I've ever handled, but no rush, why not hit that subscribe button and let's see the rest of the items that comes bundled in the box of the Technocamera 17 Pro. The device comes with complete accessories in the box, which can all be seen at a glance. You have your 13-month warranty card. There is a transparent rubber protective casing and it fits in firmly onto the device. In a smaller package, you will find the SIM ejector tool attached and within you have your USB-A to USB-C cable and a pair of earphones, which is nice to see. Most devices at this price point currently do not have earphones in the box. The last item in the box is a 25W charging brick. There is a screen protector already pre-installed on the device. The Technocamera 17 Pro has a couple of selling points, most notable being its 48MP clear selfie camera, the Helio G95 processor, 90Hz refresh rate, amongst other features. If I'm correct, this is actually the first device from Techno Mobile sporting a center hole punch selfie camera style and it's a much welcome improvement. What we hope to see next is a Super AMOLED display, fingers crossed for that one. The Technocamera 17 Pro has quite a solid design and build with Gorilla Glass on the display. The rear feels like plastic but Techno calls it organic glass and drop resistant. It has a nice feel, close to a frosted or matte finish and it's going to repel smudges and fingerprints to a good extent. If you look carefully at the design of the Technocamera 17 Pro, you'll notice a little detail underneath its rear finish. It has a linear pattern. You have the shiny and reflective Camon branding boldly to the bottom left. This is the ice silver color. Its quad rear cameras are arranged vertically to the left of the rear in a two-level camera bump, with the first level housing its quad LED flash. There is also a single front-facing flash atop the display. The frame of the Technocamera 17 Pro is plastic and it houses its ports and buttons. To the left we have the individual volume rocker keys, which has a somewhat rough pattern unlike what we're used to. The fingerprint scanner is just below and it doubles as the power button. It is easy to reach and pretty fast to unlock your device, also mostly accurate. On the left you have the dual nano SIM card slot with an extra slot for a micro SD card. The headphone jack, USB-C ports, mic and one of the dual speakers are placed at the bottom of the device. At the top you have just the second mic. The second speaker is positioned just above the display. Its stereo speakers are actually loud and it should meet your expectations. The Technocamera 17 Pro stands tall at 6.8 inches. It is not one you should consider for one-handed use, but its curved rear edges makes it a little bit comfortable to hold on one hand. The display here is a 1080x2460 LCD display with 500 nits of brightness, 395 pixels per inch and 82% screen to body ratio. While most of us would have preferred an AMOLED display for all the right reasons, this also works. With the selfie camera centered, you will enjoy watching and streaming content here, especially with the stereo speakers to complement. The 90Hz screen refresh rate makes operating this device a fluid and enjoyable experience. There is no stutter when scrolling through the UI and in my experience so far, this is not your random 90Hz experience, it is actually pretty good. You have 90Hz enabled by default and you have the option to set it to 60Hz to get more out of your battery life or have it switch automatically as needed. The software on the Camera 17 Pro is iOS 7.6 on Android 11. iOS 7.6 brings a lot of new and improved features alongside a lot of unwanted apps that you may have to go through on installing and disabling. It is also more aggressive with ads. I've only had this for about 48 hours, so expect a later review which should contain more details about the new features of iOS 7.6, but to mention a few, you can now schedule dark mode to turn on and off automatically. There is also peek proof which gives you more privacy and can prevent others from peeking while you operate your device. It's going to darken a selected part of the display and only show the part you want it to show. The Technocamera 17 Pro packs a massive 256GB of internal storage and you can use a microSD card if that is not enough. With 8GB of RAM, it is able to handle whatever apps or multitasking you throw at it. The Helio G95 is an upgrade to the G90T found on the predecessor, the Camera 16 Premiere. Though not by much, it has a 5% better GPU performance. Its benchmark scores are very impressive on the likes of AnTuTu and Geekbench, and this puts it toe-to-toe with the likes of the Redmi Note 10 Pro and the Samsung Galaxy A52 when it comes to performance. It has the Mali G76 for its GPU and smooth gaming performance is expected. I played Call of Duty Mobile and was able to do so smoothly on high graphics and maximum frame rates without lags. We'll test other games in another review to see how it fares with the likes of Genshin Impact. The Tecno Camon 17 Pro has a 5000mAh battery and so far battery life has been solid. It has a 25W fast charger in the box which is expected to power it up in a short time, but surprisingly in my experience charging this device, it took me 2 hours and 30 minutes to power it up from 0 to 100. I'm not sure why, I expected it to be significantly faster. The cameras of the Tecno Camon 17 Pro is one of its major selling points. It is dubbed the clearest selfie camera. It has a 48 megapixel selfie camera placed on the display. On the rear, we have a quad camera combination of a 64 megapixel main camera, an 8 megapixel ultra wide, 2 megapixel depth sensor and a 2 megapixel sensor called black or white. Not sure what that is going to do. Its cameras certainly do not disappoint and it has been up to expectations from the few pictures I've shot. To access high resolution mode from either its selfie or rear camera, you can swipe up from the camera menu and select Ultra HD. With this mode, you can shoot high resolution photos from either its selfie or its rear cameras. By default, it takes 12 megapixel shots from its selfie camera and 16 megapixel shots from its main camera. It uses pixel binning to achieve the higher resolution photos. The Tecno Camon 17 Pro also shines with its regular selfie shots. It looks sharp and actually quite impressive. Where it begins to struggle a bit is with portrait selfies. It does a good job of blurring out the background, but it sometimes overexposes it. Of course, this is still early and can be fixed with updates, and it was also a very sunny day. I'm going to test more for another review. There are also other camera modes, including film mode, which allows you to take a couple of shots and merges them with nice transitions and sound. Super night mode is also impressive and allows you to take better pictures at night. The Tecno Camon 17 Pro is capable of recording at 4K 30fps from both front and rear cameras. You can get electronic stabilization at 1080p.
Okay, hello guys. So you are looking at a 4K 30fps video sample from the selfie camera of the Tecno Camon 17 Pro. It is also able to do 4K 30fps from its rear cameras, and to get stabilization, you can only do that at 1080p 30fps. What do you think about the video quality and the microphone quality? Peace.
I mentioned at the beginning that this is the fastest Tecno device I've ever used, and I'm still maintaining that stance. The only real complaint I can have about the Camon 17 Pro is iOS and its ads. Take that out of the way and you have a solid device with a good 90Hz experience, enough RAM and memory, and also good camera performance. You'll definitely be seeing another review of the Tecno Camon 17 Pro after I spend more time with it. So if you have anything specific you want me to test, do leave a comment in the comment section. If you find this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to the channel. See you in the next one. Peace.